Hey guys, my name is Simidele Awa and welcome to Dear Young Christian.
This scripture was one of the first scriptures that I learned as a child. I've known the scripture by heart probably since the age of 10. And as much as I have heard the scripture and recited the scripture and quoted the scripture, it didn't really hit home with me what this scripture actually meant until this year. On New Year's Eve, me and my sister got into this terrible car accident. And to the glory of God, we made it out alive. And you know, we had a couple sprains, but we were fine. Like, that was truly a testimony. But that night, while everybody was like celebrating making it into 2018, I was reflecting on my life. Why did you allow this one to happen? It kind of flashed me back to when I was 17 years old, and I told him that I did not want to be in control of my life anymore. I wanted to dedicate my entire life to whatever he wanted me to do. After I said that prayer, God was like, "Bet, let's go." And he started using me for his glory, and I was very resistant. I wanted things to go my way. I wanted things to go the way I had planned them. There was a reason that I did what I did, and there's a reason that I majored in what I majored in, and there's a reason that I'm here at UT. And when you take driving classes, they tell you when you start skidding that you should not try to brake or you're going to make the accident worse. You're supposed to let it go and let it ride. And if you don't let it go, the damage to the car is gonna be way worse because you're adding a force that doesn't need to be there. And that's exactly what happened in the car accident that day. And God literally spoke to me. He's like, "You have to let your life go and let it ride because I am in control. Your force is unnecessary. It's going to hurt you more than it's going to help you." Trusting in the Lord is so much easier said than done, because when a situation is staring you in the face, it's really hard to trust in a God that you cannot see physically. But maybe this perspective might help. We literally only see the four corners of our lives. So wouldn't it just make more logical sense to trust in the one that knows it all and sees it all? Trusting God will save you from sleepless nights. It will save you from heartaches. It will save you money. It will save you time. It'll save you from bad relationships. It'll make you more efficient. Like, it will definitively change your life. Start committing everything that you do to him. Every project, every career choice, every assignment, every movement, everything, even what you wear, commit it to him. He is there for it. Allow him to guide your steps. He actually does not need your help. Like, he got this. And he's fully able to control your life without your input. All right, guys, all I have for today. I hope y'all have an amazing day. Don't forget, it's very possible to be saved and successful. Have a good one. Bye.